Roy Hinson, who you might remember, had a long run in the NBA, 8 years. The bulk of it with the Cleveland Cavs, one of the best power forwards on the West Coast last year in high school basketball. And the Matadors overcoming their shooting woes that cost them so dearly Thursday night in Santa Barbara. Witten goes glass.
I really like the way the Mustangs are attacking the Matadors' pressure defense.
4 points now for Witten. Going the other way.
Last week when we watched CSUN play defense, convert, and that's what he's able to do. That's why he's shooting 43% from the field, 42% from downtown. He's a solid player.
Darwin played his high school basketball at Monroe High School, averaged 16 points a year ago, and I think he has impressed the coaches with his ability to have breakout games. Dropped 29 on Utah. And if they get any offensive activity out of Johnson, it's a bonus because he's there primarily for his shot blocking alterations and his rebounding. They pick up the pressure, and Braswell calls it one a year ago. And for Gray, I think there was more of a jarring repercussion because the other two graduated. Right. Probably knew they were done. Gray was an academic eligibility issue, and they had to wait all the way until the end of December to find out about this semester, and he is done for the year. He's a player who dropped 35 on Irvine last year, 32 against USC at the Sports Arena.
And you really got to look at the pressure that the Mustangs are applying. You talked about the pressure of the Matadors. It's the Mustangs scrambling and running all over the floor, very active on the defensive end.
Jones felt that pressure, moved to the long shot clock at 5. Witten elevates and drops it in as he tumbles to the floor.
Tough shot right there by Dobbin. Very nice move to the baseline. Two guys right there, floats it in with a nice arc.
Dobbin White has really picked up his intensity defensively. He's also one of the best steal operators in this conference as ever.
Nice touch.
Calipari maintaining their composure and hanging around the scoreboard. Down by just 4. And up on the 12-minute mark, opening half. They played very well Thursday night with the Mustangs losing to UOP, and that had opened a confidence boost even in defeat. Finnegan has to play, beat the clock, and he does. Young man doesn't score that much, only 6 points on average, but really has that sort of court savvy the coaches like.
Yeah, he lost his defender right there as he made the cut across the key, but nice patience by the Mustangs. They're not in a hurry. They're not startled by the pressure of the Matador.
Lead down to 2. Here's White into the lane, nothing doing. Witten going the other way, going to the hoop and finishing.
Nice move. He could have gone up for the dunk, but instead he recognized the defender was right on his back, shielded him off, and finished it hard to the hole.
His half-brother Harvey Witten would appreciate that defensive effort. He plays cornerback at Oregon State, and we're level at 19 on the campus of Cal Poly SLO. Back door open for White. He drops it in. Nice look from Shoemaker up top.
Yeah, and that's what they love to do, the Matadors. They like to get you stretched out, try to find holes, and get you to the back door. White's come off the bench. He's 2 for 2 from the field with 4 points. That's the impact. That's why he's back-to-back Big West Conference Player of the Week.
McGinn drops the baseline, moving along for Johnson. Going to the line, Shoemaker.
Nice move to the basket, aggressive move to the basket. That's what the coaches really want to see out of Johnson. He really hasn't. You know, he's got such a big frame, but he's kind of slow. He's kind of a little stumbling with the pins.
11 a.m. What do you do with Michael Vick? And what do you do with the snow? A nor'easter blanketing.
Will DVD get off, or will they be held in check by that stingy Philadelphia Eagles defense? I know Jerry Weinstein, our producer, very upset that the Rams aren't in the NFC Championship game, but he said he kind of expected it after the way the Rams played all season long.
Did you beat your J-Dub reference from last week? I can't recall the mark in the first half, but you are just that versatile, sliding in Jerry's. Terrific work. Shoemaker wisely sits with the 2 personal fouls. Johnson on the line, 70%, and he has battled some health issues, a bad back, forced him to redshirt last year, and last week took an elbow to the mouth, had stitches both inside and outside of his mouth.
And that is not good. Interesting thing coming up. Look at the 1-3-1 defense being applied now by the Mustangs. Usually it's the Matadors that are applying that defense, and now it's the Mustangs.
We touched on the steal number, and I think he hit on it accurately, showing a
flattering.
I've heard that. Did you know that?
I think I should patent that.
Again, the foul. Foul's getting tighter, but CSUN one away from sending Cal Poly into the bonus as we wiggle closer to the 10-minute mark in a nifty move on the move, dropped in by Hurt.
After watching Hurt for the last 2 weeks, the thing that really impresses me is his ability to get to the rim. He's got that wiry finisher on the hoop. He's got 6 points on 3 of 5 shooting. Tyler McGinn for 3. We saw the hops again by a pretty talented group of Mustangs. Haskins couldn't do enough to get efficient with a soft touch around the hoop. The freshman out of Inglewood, California, has really done a nice job so far for Bobby Braswell and the Matadors. He's been steady so far at the line. 76 coming in. Tichenor got him. Average a double-double a year ago at Dorsey High. 18 points, 10 rebounds. All-City in L.A. was his team MVP and did it all. And making the honor roll, and that's important to Braswell. He really does preach character, as borne out by the suspension this year. You recall a year ago, 3 players were asked not to play. Another way of saying suspended for a big part of the second half of the Big West regular season.
Bobby Braswell is an excellent coach and an excellent, excellent disciplinarian, and that's why you see his team, even though they lead the country in steals, they really do a great job just swarming on the defense end. They don't give up easy looks.
Yeah, they play on the move under control. Lock backs it up. Brad at Crossroads High School. They know something about 5-yard play.
And a guy by the name of Darren Davis, who's pretty good.
Good defensive set here, but the Matadors hang in and find a way to drop it in. Sal Vance doesn't do much offensively, but he's matched his average of a bucket.
He was great at Skyline Junior College, where he averaged 15 points and 8 rebounds a game, and he's coming now and still trying to find his own here at Northridge.
26-20 CSUN. It'll stay that way. Mustangs going to the glass, but here come the Matadors in transition. Boylan still yet to do a great deal offensively. Cannot roll it in off the glass. Glenn Jones going to push. Senior from Quartz Hill.
Good job flattening out the defense and reestablishing the offense and getting it set up here for the Mustangs.
Again, sees a double come his way from that zone look. Skip pass. Kitchenoff, catch and shoot for 3.
They worked on that play at least 3 quarters of their shoot-around today. A great job bringing the opposite guy all the way across, making that bottom guy run all the way there. Skip pass over the top is the one that they're going to give you. And if you can knock down that shot, you're going to have some success.
3-point game. Vance, too aggressive off the glass. Jones had a career-high 7 dishes Thursday night, tries to take it himself, and that leads to the opportunity for CSUN. Once more, Hurd looking swift, moving down the floor.
Well, that is a good foul. I think that's a foul to earn it. He was 1 of 2 so far in the game, so if he hits 1 of 2 again, you come out 1 point ahead, because otherwise he'll give it up 2.
Tichenor's 2nd personal foul. And we'll see some wholesale shifts. These teams, not ultra deep, but the real issue for Cal Poly is how do they find a player like Boylan? It just seems to me that the Mustangs really lack a go-to threat offensively, whereas when CSUN gets in trouble, the Boylan, or as we saw most deliberately last week on FSN, they went to White against Utah State to pull out the win.
And I think that's being developed here. I think when you look at Witten or you look at Haskins, two guys that are freshmen that are going to continue to get better under Kevin Bromley, and as they continue to grow and mature into Division I players, they're going to be that consistent threat, so I think the future is bright. Right out field!
Here goes Radames. Darwin drops it in. He rails him at a 42% clip. It's number 6 in this conference for 3-point range.
Now it comes down to getting stops on the defensive end of the floor for the Mustangs. Every time they hit a big basket, they're giving them right back up.
Wilder step into the passing lane, forcing the turnover, and the Mustangs could tie or take the lead with a 3 on this sequence. Witten for 3. It comes off to Haskins. It was a prolific scorer in high school. The state of Washington, as a junior, led the state, and that guy knows how to finish. Gets around.